Hello, everyone. Welcome to another year of our Women's Ministries Convention. I hope you will stay tuned with us and enjoy. My name is Olga Thorpe, and my partner here is...
I'm Alda Thilofernes.
And I am so happy that you're with us, because we will be your host for this weekend. Oh, it's going to be a great time. Can you tell me what is our theme for this year?
We have an amazing theme. It says, I will go sharing my legacy.
Wow, and what a legacy we have to share with others around us. I hope that as we tune in tonight, we can enjoy this program. But you know, Aldit, I don't think this weekend's program is only going to be for Friday night.
No.
So tomorrow, right, at 9:30 through 12:30 in the morning, we want to encourage you to come out and enjoy this really awesome program planned for you.
And it will continue at 3:30 p.m. until 5:30 in the afternoon.
Yes, don't forget, because you don't want to lose all we have in store for you.
We have dynamic great speakers and other things prepared for you. So give us your 100% attention, brace yourself, and enjoy the program.
Yes.
On behalf of the New Jersey Conference Administration and in the name of our Lord Jesus, I want to thank all of you for your support of our mission to share the message of hope to others. Thank you for the help that you have given to the activities of the church in the midst of this pandemic. Thank you for your faithfulness and your tithe and offering in support of the local ministry and at the conference-wide level. I always admire the strength, fidelity, dedication, and I value very much the sacrifice of women to make their homes, church, and society a better place. Thank you for the spiritual value of our ladies that can communicate in a unique way and many times more effective than us as men. It is a privilege for me. I will go listening the voice of God.
And your core, deeply loved. see tomorrow with no pain. We're connected by the love of our Savior Jesus Christ, that His precious blood He shed on Calvary. As we share the hope of Jesus, our faith is growing strong. And get connected to one another, bringing sinners to His throne. When our Savior comes in glory and in majesty, of His grace abounding mercy, we'll forever see. Our steps will be guided by the Spirit of the Lord, and the bride is getting ready for the groom. He is coming in the clouds, every eye shall see His face, and the heavens will forever sing His praise. As we share the hope of Jesus, our faith is growing strong. Worship Him in heaven and bow down before the throne, and the glory of His face at last we'll see. For the scars He wore for me on His hands and on His feet, my redemption story He will share with me. As we share the hope of Jesus, our faith is growing strong.
Ladies of New Jersey Conference, this is your friend Sarah Capellas for Delhi. I come to you with a dynamic of prayer. This weekend, we are going to lift up in prayer all of our leaders, especially our pastors. What we want you to do is set up an alarm every hour or every 2 hours. And when the alarm goes off, you're going to set aside 5 minutes of your time to pray for your pastor. We want you also to pray for the administration of the New Jersey Conference and the administration of the General Conference. They need our prayers. All of our pastors, all of our leaders need our prayers. And we're going to be doing so this weekend. Also, thereafter, if you want to continue praying, which we do encourage for you to do so, please continue praying for our leaders. Let's continue praying until Jesus comes. God bless you.
Created for a mission, I was brought to this world to preach to every kindred of His mercy and love. In every kindness I show, in everything that I do, I've been chosen by my God to testify. A woman of God, I'm His masterpiece, chosen, loved, and redeemed by His love. A new life I was given to serve. I accept Your call. Here I am, my Lord. Shout and sing, Lord, I will go. Women of God are preaching about His redemptive love, sharing God's love and mercy, forgiveness and joy. I will not be afraid. God is walking by my side. I will go forward with His back. The ending is near. I'm a man of God. I'm His masterpiece, chosen, love, and redeemed. A new life I was given to serve. I accept Your call. Here I am, my Lord. Wherever I go, I will tell, and forever will I shout and sing, Lord, I will go.
As a woman, mother, wife, and with parents as they're aging, it is difficult as your parents age that you're taking them to doctors and watching them have some life difficulties with their health. Sometimes it could become burdensome, you know. And while you're taking care of all of that, you start wondering if God's hand is in all of this. So my personal testimony as a woman, I would take care of my parents, take them from doctor's visits to doctor's visits, watch my father's life deteriorate little by little, and also watch my mother with her health problems lose little pieces of herself as a person struggling with diabetes and having issues with infections in her feet. So as life continues, you know, it starts becoming a little bit more burdensome. And so you start wondering, and I started wondering, Lord, what's going on? And now with COVID happening, how are we going to deal with this? Right before COVID started, my father ended up in the hospital. And they diagnosed him with something that was supposed to be done in a week. And my mom went to go visit him as a loving wife, as a woman, to be with her companion, who they've been together for 50 years. Very connected. People of God. They trusted God so much that they put God in the center of their family, and they lasted together 50 years. Now, right before COVID happened, when my mom went to visit him, she ended up falling and breaking her shoulder and ended up in the hospital herself. And I could see how God's hand was playing a little bit in this, because it was getting a little difficult to see my father in the hospital and go see my mother, who was staying by herself at her house. And taking care of both of them was becoming a struggle at that point, because they were both separate. Now, yes, I know something bad happened to her, but she ended up in the same hospital as him. So I had to only go to one hospital to go take care of them. As bad as that may sound, God's hand was playing there, allowing me to just have to go one location to take care of them both. My mother then ended up in rehab, and my father shortly after was moved to the same rehab as her. Again, God fulfilling another prayer, so that I wouldn't have to deal with having to, and it wasn't that I made it that way, God made it that way. So now I ended up having to just go to one location again to take care of both of my parents. But let's fast forward. COVID happens. My mother gets released from the hospital, and once again I see myself having to go to two separate places. My father in the rehab, my mother in her house. Again, back where we started. She was struggling still because she had not fully healed from her shoulder. And again, I reached out to God. God, pass from me this cup, because I don't know what's going to happen. Now COVID happened and the rehab center shut down. And now my father was by himself there without us being able to visit him. And my mother was by herself in her apartment. And some restrictions started to happen at the apartment house as well. Of course, she was struggling still because she was home alone with me taking care of her and no home health aide coming to her rescue. So everything fell on me. And I remember one day just asking God, God, pass from me this cup. And even though sometimes you sit there and you wonder, is that bad to ask for? You know, they did live a full life. And when I look back, I see my father and my mother dedicated their entire life to God's ways, to making sure that his message to whomever they came across went through, okay? Even in the little things that my father would do, cleaning the floor, being an elder, being a deacon, he was even a member of the Pathfinder Club as a staff member. So as soon as my father became an Adventist, he dedicated his whole entire life to God. It didn't stop there. Even when he was in his bed in the hospital, he would still talk to people about what to do, love one another, make sure that you are loving to each other. That's what's most important, to follow God. Well, going back to my prayer, God, pass from me this cup. My mother was just 75 years old. She had just turned 75. And she's home alone. I'm going between work, her house, taking care of my family. All of these things that you seem to do as a mother, as a wife, as a person of God. And also, while taking care of our children in our churches who didn't have a way to communicate with their staff, you know, their church leaders. And we have Zoom pop up, start to do Sabbath school, start to do club ministries. While this is happening, the shutdown began. Pass from me this cup. Some words, right? Well, guess what? One day, my mother was no longer with us. She fell in the tub. She was very headstrong. So even if we told her not to go in the tub while she was by herself, she went to take a shower. And I called her to find out what she needed, and she wasn't answering the phone. When I get to her house, there she was, lying in the tub. And, you know, from one day to the next, she was there, full of life, and the next day she was not. Well, once I told my father the news, I kind of knew what was going to happen soon after. They were so connected to each other, and of course connected to God, that once he knew that she was okay, I mean, even though she had passed away, he too rested. 9 days later, I get a phone call that my father had also passed. Yes. Pass from me this cup turned into this one way of closing their chapter on this earth while waiting in the Lord. Yes, I know for sure, I am very, very sure that they will be on Resurrection Day waiting for God to return. Why do I know this? I saw their example throughout all their life. I knew that they, as a family, we as a family, yes, we struggled, but I know for sure because of the way they conducted their life. I too wish to conduct that in the same manner, which is why I try to dedicate all the time, all the free time that I have to helping others. I hope this testimony helps you in your personal life. If you're struggling with a parent, or parents with health problems, don't despair and don't feel guilty if you ask God to pass from you this cup. I hope God blesses you. May God be with you. Thank you for hearing.
Majesty and
Welcome back again. We are so happy to have you, and we know that you have enjoyed those selections. Astrid, tell me about it. Did you enjoy that?
I love the music, and I am so empowered by the testimonies.
It was awesome. We are filled. But do you know there's more to come?
Yes, and our first topic is I Will Go Empowered by Sister Blackman.
Wow, yes, we need some empowerment in these days. That is such a good and awesome topic. So right now, we are going to leave it up to our dear Sister Blackman, and she is going to explain how we can get empowered. Norca Blackman was born in Central America in the country of Panama to Adventist ministerial missionaries, now retired. As such, she was privileged to complete her elementary and high school education in the British, Latin American, and Dutch educational system. Wow! Norca understands that her life's calling is to be an advocate who empowers but also speak truth to power against oppression, inequality, and marginalization. She also manifests this calling in all aspects of her personal, professional, and spiritual life. She is the president and founder of For Real Women's International Incorporated, a nonprofit 501 nonprofit with headquarters in New York and regional operations in the USA, Latin America, and the Caribbean. During the year 2020, despite the global pandemic, more than 80 of For Real Women trained volunteers serviced over 1,200 women and more than 900 girls ages 12 through 17 in their communities. What an awesome job. So this is this powerful person we will be listening to tonight, and we hope as we listen, we will be empowered. Now we leave with you Norca Blackman Richards.
My name is Norca Blackman Richards, and I bring greetings to you from Baldwin, New York, where I reside, and the Northeastern Conference, where my husband and I currently serve. It is such a great honor to be with you, and I would like to acknowledge with appreciation the invitation to be part of the New Jersey Conference Virtual Convention for Women. I Will Go Share My Legacy. In a special way, I want to thank Sister Naomi Torres for inviting or extending this invitation to me to speak to you today. Greetings and hugs and blessings to our sisters from the New Jersey Conference, our sisters in other states and countries around the world who are joining us for this broadcast or who will be joining us by watching the recording in days to come. We salute you. Our topic for today is empowered. And my dear sisters, I want to say to you that I'm passing here briefly to let you know today that you are braver than you think. You are stronger than you seem. Much smarter than you think. Your contributions are valuable. You're twice more beautiful than you imagine because you were created in the image and likeness of a perfect God. And you have more going for you than against you because you're an empowered woman. How can I assure you of this? You see, God does not make mistakes. God is not a creator of imperfections, nor does he have the ability to lie. He would not have created you if he had known that in you he could not have placed the potential to succeed. You see, before your birth, he placed that potential in you. You were not born, You did not come here by chance. You are not a mistake. Let me lay the foundation for a short time together by sharing a definition of the word empowered. Empowered means that you have been given the authority or the power to do something. You have been given the authority or the power to do something. 2 Timothy 1:7 reminds us that God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power, of love, and of a sound mind. And if you still have doubts after reading that about the scope and the power of that authority that he has given you, let me remind you that Luke 10:19 tells us, "Behold, I give unto you power to tread on serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you." As an empowered woman, God has given you the power of transformation. It is part of your God-given legacy. Today, I want to give you proof of 5 of your abilities of empowerment. 5 abilities of empowerment with proof. Reason number 1, your life is a divine plan. Before the day of your birth, God had already a plan for your life. Jeremiah 1:5 tells us that before he formed you in the womb of your mother, God already knew you. And before you were born, he sanctified you. When you came to this earth, you came with the power of his sanctification and his knowledge. And for that plan to be fulfilled, you have to learn to see yourself through the eyes of your Creator. You see, he sees you through his eyes of mercy and love. You must also learn to love yourself as he loves you. Reason number 2, you are a legitimate daughter of God. You are an empowered woman because you're a legitimate daughter of the King of Kings. 2 Corinthians 6:18 reminds us that he is our father and we are his daughters. You see, you're not inferior. You're not a stepsister. You're not a maid. In God's kingdom, in Jehovah God's kingdom, you are a princess. Take your position, walk like a princess, act like a princess, talk like a princess. You are royalty. Reason number 3, God has given you power. 2 Timothy 1:7 reminded us that God has given you the power to love, but he has also given you the power to control your belief system. Luke 10:19 goes on to tell us that he has also given you the power over anything or anyone who wants to harm you. But you see, empowered also means that you have to put yourself in the process of becoming a stronger person with more confidence in your life, more confident about your decisions. You understand your rights as a human being. And more importantly, you know that you are a daughter of God with all the rights and privileges that come with that. Reason number 4, you have the ability to love healthily. You see, there's toxic love and there's healthy love. Toxic love kills. Toxic love can destroy us emotionally and spiritually, and for some, tragically, toxic love can end up in death. An empowered woman recognizes healthy love and also knows how to love healthily. She understands that her love should be appreciated and respected. An empowered woman knows that whoever claims to love her, be that man, woman, or child, whoever claims to love her, but treats her with contempt, abuses her physically, verbally, financially, emotionally, and spiritually, does not love her healthily. An empowered woman understands that healthy love will have moments of disagreement, but healthy love knows how to respect, knows how to recognize guilt, knows how to ask for forgiveness, and is determined to make reparations and not to commit the same mistake. There is a law of life, simple, plain truth. No one can give you what they do not have. If you do not have healthy love for yourself, you will not have it for anyone else. If you don't know what healthy love looks like, you don't know how to differentiate between toxic love from healthy love. The Bible is clear. Love your neighbor as yourself. You need to love yourself first before you're able to love others. Healthy love then starts with you. But first, you must learn to love healthily. And love is a learned choice. And reason number 5, you understand your worth. During these times of pandemic, our collective and individual mental health has deteriorated. Anxiety, depression, fear have seized the minds and the hearts of many. Most of the time, our low self-esteem is the product of our own self-devaluation. We judge our bodies as if they were a criminal case. Too fat, too thin, too tall, too short, too light, too dark. We self-devalue ourselves as if we were old and used clothing. But I want to stop by here to remind you that your value does not depend on what you have and watch how you may look and what you wear. Your value does not depend on who surrounds you. It does not depend on your circumstances. A pearl does not lose its value because it's found in the mud. God created you according to the original model. Therefore, even if you try to become a photocopy of other women, you will only become a blurred photocopy, and you will never feel satisfied because you have not managed to understand that God made you original. In this regard, we want you to accept it, to claim it, and walk proudly in it. You are unique. You are unique. And even though you have functioned in circles of deficit and devaluation and diminishment, and you probably still function in some of these circles, you have to start the process of learning to love yourself, because to love healthily is a learned behavior. The ingredients of your empowerment are at your disposal. For the 5 reasons that I mentioned before, I also want to challenge you to begin your process of transformation today. As you begin your empowerment process, there are 4 practices, simple practices that I want to invite you to consider. 1, start each day by reading your love letter. What is your love letter? The Bible. You see, the Bible is not a book of rules and prophetic interpretations. The Bible is God's love letter to you. Every story in the Bible is a narrative with lessons for your life. Even if it is a single biblical text, propose yourself each day to carve out 15 to 30 minutes in your day, at the beginning of your day, to read your love letter. 2, repeat positive affirmations. There is scientific evidence that repeating affirmations and writing affirmations has a positive effect on our well-being, on our mental well-being. I want to challenge you to repeat a positive affirmation every day, to take the time to write it on a sticky, write it in your journal, and repeat biblical promises that will give you the positive double effect of helping with your wellness mentally and spiritually. 3, evaluate your social circle. Who is part of your influence group? Are there ego people who have elevated, uplifting thoughts about themselves, about others? They're constantly wondering how they can do good for society. They're interested in self-growth. They're positive people. Or is your circle filled with chicken people? People who go around digging in the ground, digging around people's business, criticize, complain. They don't fly very high because they lack the capacity to elevate, and definitely are not too interested in personal growth. This is a whole sermon about the chicken people and the eagle people. But if you're a Christian, even in your circle, your church friend circle, I can guarantee you that they're eagles and they're chickens. Learn to differentiate them. Evaluate your circle, as your circle will influence your ability to remain in power. Number four, take responsibility for yourself. Don't expect others to do for you what you need to and what you can do for yourself. If you need to do exercise, take responsibility for caring for your temple and for loving God's temple in you, and start taking care of yourself. If you need to eat healthier, drink more water, take responsibility for that. And remember that you're walking around with God's temple, and the embodiment of that temple needs to be taken care of. If you have suffered trauma, or you need help because you've suffered abuse, or you need to process toxic events that occurred in your childhood or your youth, take the responsibility and seek professional help. This may mean that you need to look for a counselor. It may mean that you need to check into therapy. But don't let what others haven't done for you, or have stopped doing for you, or will not do for you ever, don't let that ever stop you from doing what you need to do for yourself. Take responsibility for yourself. And in closing, I want to invite you to repeat this affirmation with me. And you can repeat it to yourself as the days go by. I am confident. I am strong. I am courageous. My contributions are valuable. I am empowered, because in Christ Jesus, I am more than a conqueror. Now, sister, I invite you, give yourself a hug. The power is in you. God gave it to you. Healthy love begins with you. Because God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power, of love, and of a sound mind. I invite you now to go and share this legacy.
Passion for your glory. Give me passion. up my own, I will go. I was brought to this world to preach to every kindred of His mercy and love. In every kindness I show, in everything that I do, I've been chosen by my God to testify. I will man of God, His masterpiece, chosen, loved, and redeemed by His love. A new life I was given to serve. I accept Your call. Here I am, my Lord. Wherever I go, I will tell, and forever will I shout and sing. About His redemptive love, sharing God's love and mercy, forgiveness and joy. I will not be afraid. God is walking by my side. I will go forward with His power. The ending is near. I will man of God, masterpiece, chosen, loved, and redeemed by His love. A new life I was given to serve. I accept Your call. Here I am, my Lord. Wherever I go, I will tell, and forever will I shout and sing. Lord, I will go.
Wow, that was invigorating. Were you blessed? Oh boy, wasn't that a great, great service and a great information that we needed, Aldit?
Yes, I was empowered and hope you too were empowered. In Testimonies Volume 4, page 642, it says, there is a higher purpose for a woman, a grander destiny. She should develop and cultivate her powers, for God can employ them in the great work of saving souls from internal ruins.
Yes, and do you know something? We are included. So let us get this empowerment and go forward. Teach others so that they too will catch a glimpse of Christ and they too will not miss out on eternal life. So, you know, we thank you all for coming. And what we are going to do now, we will be having a prayer. And then we hope that you will tune in tomorrow. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, what a great empowerment that was given to us. And we are all ready now, after such important information, to go out, empower ourselves, and then empower others so that this world will be caught on fire for you, because you are waiting for us to take our legacy and share it with the world. Thank you for our dear loving sister, Norca Blackman, and we ask that you will continue to bless her as she goes forward and she empowers others for you, so that generation through generation will see your love, your grace, and that they also will be able to say, "This is my Lord. He came to save me." Thank you for hearing us. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Wow. Can we keep this only for today?
No.
I don't think so. So what are we going to do?
Tomorrow at 9:30 in the morning, please tune in and come back with us.
We look forward to see you, and have a good night's rest.
God bless.